Hello again. Let's go to tune the system. By selecting both the clusters and then right-click, we have first to assign them to an array, with which, like in a group, we can share some parameters as gain, delay, user equalization, low frequency cluster size, mute and unmute all the modules together. Each single object can belong to an array or group only. Right-click again and connect the arrays to the venue called main we did before. Be sure to assign the cluster to an array, because if not, the connection with the design will be not available. Now, go in the Easy Shape Designer drop-down menu and select View. Look at this green button. It means that the design we called main is correctly assigned to an array because the numbers of modules in the design match the ones in the workspace. Now, by pressing Preset Apply, the cluster will get the proper high frequency and low frequency presets according with the design. You can see, looking at the green line or the preset numbers, that the modules have their own and different HF correction. Instead, they will share the same cluster size for the lows. Now the system is ready to play. And if the project has been well designed with the proper cluster curvature, we can say that in most cases, talking about the clusters, the tuning is almost done, without going on with other adjustments. It's time to listen for some tracks to verify if it is true. Sounds good. Let's keep this basic setting at the moment. Now it's time to go working with the subs. First of all, select the proper crossover for our system. In this case, 60 Hz. Select the sub, properties, and select the preset S2, 20 to 60 Hz. Make the same for the clusters, clicking in the EQ button of any modules to open the DSP settings. Go to the bottom left in the high pass filter section and type 60 Hz and then close the window. We have the sub in end fire, so we have to delay the first row to match the second one. Select the sub and right-click Function, New, End Fire. Make sure that the subs are graphically aligned because the software uses their position to give them its numbering that must be in this way. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It will determine to which sub the software will send the delay for the configuration. Now, type the number of rows, 2, and the distance between them, 1.5 meters. Close. The end fire is done. Right-click again on the sub. Function, New, Master. It allows to create a master function to manage the gain and the phase alignment of the already configured subs. To do it, launch Smart Live and get the phase plot of the clusters, placing the measurement microphone around the front of house position, of course with the subs in mute. Here we can see the phase plot of the tops around the crossover point. Capture. Mute the clusters and unmute the subs. Now, probably, we have to apply a delay with the master function of the subs until its phase plot in the crossover point will overlap or at least will be similar to the one of the clusters. Here we are. Capture. To verify that the subs are properly aligned, unmute the tops and see if in the crossover area we can see a sum of the two systems each other. Here we are. Capture. You can see the tops, the subs, and their sum. Let's do a double check. Remove from the view the tops and the sub plot, then reverse the polarity of the subs to see how important alignment is. Look, with the sub not aligned, there is a huge amount of energy lost in this area because of the cancellation due to the wrong phase. Of course, come back with the right polarity. We can listen for some tracks with subs to find the right level for them. See you in the next video for the system fine-tuning. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.